Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss linear equations in two variables. Let's work through this example very carefully. The question says, find the equation of the line that passes through negative 1, 2 and is perpendicular to y equals negative 1 third x plus 5. Solution. So in general, whenever you're looking for the equation of a line, you need two things. You need a point and you need a slope. Well, we're already given the point. It's negative 1, 2. So we just need to find the slope. So we are told that our line is perpendicular to this line over here. The slope of this line is just negative 1 third because it's in the form y equals mx plus b. Right, if you write it like this, you can see right away that m is equal to negative 1 third. However, our line is perpendicular to it. So our slope is just the negative reciprocal. So you basically flip it and put a negative sign. It's going to become 3. So whenever it's perpendicular and you know that your line is perpendicular to another line, you just take the slope of that line and you flip it and you put a negative. Okay, so now we have our slope. We also have our point, which I'll label as x1, y1. We can use the point slope formula for a line, which says that y minus y1 is equal to m parentheses and then x minus x1. It's really a good idea to write these down every time you do one of these problems. That way you end up memorizing it. And so this is y minus, so y1 is 2. And then our m is 3, and then parentheses, and then we have x. So it's x minus negative 1. So it's already negative, and there's a minus here, so it's going to become a plus because of the double negative. So we have y minus 2 equals 3 times x is 3x, and then 3 times 1 is 3. And we just add 2 to both sides, so plus 2 plus 2. And so we end up with y equals 3x plus 5. Pretty cool. So this line would be perpendicular to the line given in the problem, and it passes through negative 1, 2. So again, whenever you have a line that's perpendicular to another line, the slope of your line is the negative reciprocal. So you just flip it and put a negative. What if it said parallel? Let's just think about that for a moment. So if it was parallel, so if it said parallel in the question, then it would be a little bit different. If this particular question said parallel, then, well, parallel lines have the same slope. So in this case, m would just be negative 1 third. So whenever it's parallel, you're going to have the same slope because parallel lines have the same slope. Whenever it's perpendicular, it's going to be the negative reciprocal, so you just flip it and put a negative. Hopefully this video has taught you some mathematics. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.